Hey folks, Jim with Smoky Lake Maple Products here. Today we are going to do a demonstration on the installation of the forced draft pressure cabinet and blower system that is now an available option for the Dauntless Evaporator. This new system is going to work on every Dauntless Evaporator that was ever made. It comes with everything you need that on the spirit of the Dauntless and StarCat evaporators, it is a self-assembly thing. But if you've assembled your Dauntless, then this thing is going to be real easy to install. It's a handful of bolts. So let's get going on the unboxing, and then we'll get into the assembly and installation. Even if you bought the Dauntless evaporator system at the same time as the forced draft, good chance you're going to see it boxed separately anyway. It's just what we do to make sure that everything is properly packed and that there's nothing missing. So we've been doing that in bulk. Part of the forced draft system, and probably the least exciting part, is we do send a heavy duty exhaust elbow with it. The evaporator is now going to be capable of reaching temperatures which could be dangerous for a lighter weight elbow. Like all of our evaporators, we use top quality Dayton blowers. I'm just going to unbox the blower from its separate box and set it aside. There is a hardware kit and a front plate and a rear plate for the pressure cabinet. And finally, the pressure cabinet itself, the main body of it. The front plate, we are also going to set off to the side for now because that does not go on until the very end. So let's pop our hardware kit open. Your hardware kit should have 12 of the half inch long quarter inch bolts and four of the 3/4 by 1/4 inch bolts. There should be 20 washers. This particular package had three extra washers. And then there should be 16 lock nuts. The kit does not come with the hardware for mounting the pressure cabinet inside of the arch. In almost all cases, you have your arch bolted together, and the bolts you take off, you're going to be putting back in. If you have an evaporator, a Dauntless evaporator that's been factory assembled, which is going to be like 1 in 100 because most of them that we send out are they're assembled on site. So, but if you do get that, if you do have an evaporator that has been factory assembled, you'll find that the fasteners are rivets instead of bolts.
Oh, okay. So this is an example of a factory assembled.
Yep, because we're in our showroom here, so we have rivets in instead of bolts, which would typically be in place. So in that case, you will have to get some bolts to put it back together or rivet it back together again. I love rivets. Rivets are extremely strong. So if you have a rivet gun and some rivets handy, you can rivet it back together too, whatever you prefer. Bolts are handy. So as we get going on this, the first thing I'm going to do is mount the blower onto the rear plate. We want the blower to be hanging like such inside of the evaporator. We don't want it to be tall upward from the mounting holes. We want it to drop underneath. That's the most important thing when you put this on.
Oh, cool. Show me from the side.
Yep. So these holes on the rear plate of the pressure cabinet have to line up with the holes here. This is the floor, this is the bottom. So you need to already start thinking about that orientation when you put the blower on. These holes are strongly offset toward the bottom.
Yep.
And they are here too, and you want the blower to hang downward. What we're gonna do, we're gonna take the 3/4 inch bolts using a washer on each side. We are assembling. Whether the nuts be on the inside or the outside of the pressure cabinet really makes no difference at all. The temperatures in the pressure cabinet are always going to be basically what your ambient temperature is around you. All of your wrenches that you're using are 7/16 for the nut and for the bolt, all around the entire build. If you're doing this with your son or grandson, don't use a tool like this. Make it last as long as possible.
Yeah, right. It's okay to take your time. Next, let's attach that back plate to the pressure cabinet. You're going to notice that the top row of holes on the side of the pressure cabinet are not exactly centered. They're offset a little bit. See here, this end has more space compared to this end, which has less space. We want to mount that blower to the end that has less space between the holes and the edge, just as shown in this photo.
There we go, bolt slides right in. Now a washer. On the washer, you have the radiused side of the washer, and you have the bottom side of the washer, which has a burr. Sometimes it's sharp. Always noticeable though. That's from when they punch these things out. The burr is turned downward as they punch these. I am very picky. I always put the burred side against the product. It makes it just a little bit more streamlined, and it's not something very many people would notice, but it's important to me. It is just easier to put them all in first, then tighten them at the end, all at once. And the power tool is great, but I just remember doing things like this with my dad, and I wished it would have taken longer. You know, they're good memories. All right, so the rear of the pressure cabinet is done, and it is ready to go in. So let's go ahead and drill the rivets out that we need removed. In no case, whether you have a bolt together evaporator or a riveted one, will you ever remove that fastener. That stays there, and we designed the forest draft kit based on that. We don't want that one to be removed because it is somewhat integral to keep your spacing for your draft slide. So we didn't want that to ever really be removed, because then it's something the spacing has to be dealt with again. So that's why we designed it in the way we did. So we're going to go ahead and remove the five rivets or bolts, if you more than likely have a bolt together evaporator. Remove the five fasteners behind the front one.
And you did this on both sides, right?
Correct. With the fasteners removed, let's get to putting it together.
All right.
If you have someone to help you, this is the part where it would be, it'd be beneficial to have someone hold one side up for you while you slide this in. I've done it myself, and I will manage again for this video, but this is the part where you might want some help. This is the hardware that you just got done taking out. It's going right back in. You get one in just to hold it. And like I do with all things, the washer is going in the proper way. And like I do with most things, I'm going to put all the fasteners in before I tighten any of them.
So this is a half inch bolt.
This is a quarter inch bolt, 3/4 inch long. These are the same ones that you pulled out of your evaporator to start this install.
Okay.
In this case, we had a factory assembled unit. We drilled them out. That was good for demonstration. But almost all of the folks out there are gonna be disassembling with regular threaded hardware. And the holes line up perfectly. There's no struggle. They're all CNC cut, of course. So everything lines up and fits up really nice. It's another one of those projects which is really satisfying to do. It's a lot of fun. So I have a bolt in the front right corner, the rear right corner. Now I'm gonna put a bolt through the other corners as well. It's such a perfect fit. It's really satisfying to watch it come together the way it does. Now I have the four corners held up with a bolt. Now in any random order you can put the rest of them in. And so it might be helpful to note that adding the forced draft does not require you to do anything with your fire brick or insulation. It doesn't interfere with any of that stuff, and in no case do you have to ever remove any of the fire brick or insulation.
Will you have to remove any ash or anything from the pressure cabinet during this?
Very little. So even without a forest draft, as most people who have run a Dauntless or any kind of a professionally made evaporator know, there's not much ash that comes out of the grates. There's not much that falls through. But there's going to be even less with forest draft. It's going to be burning cleaner, and it's going to be...
It's pushing out.
Away.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so the arch is already back together. The fasteners are back in along the side spines of the assembly. If you guys are going to be using a electronic wrench like this, especially the hammer type, be careful. This is grade 5 hardware. It's standard hardware. It does break if you really reef on it with these or by hand. So the last thing to do on the actual assembly part of it is to put the front access panel on. And now you can see why we didn't put that on yet, because it was imperative for us to be able to reach in to put those bolts back in.
Right.
With this not in place. And this will be your access. If for some reason you need to take the unit back off, or if you have to get in there to do some end of season cleaning, this is your access panel. 6 bolts hold it on, and removing 6 bolts gets you back in there. So again, the holes are low on the pressure cabinet, so the holes are low on the access panel too. And it fits nice and snug. It's a perfect fit, so it goes in only one way. I'm going to get one bolt in over here, and I'm going to get one started right here, just so as I pound this into position up here, just to keep it from sliding around. I'm going to get those all situated so that as I put it into place in one spot, it doesn't swing out in another.
Yeah.
So the bolt goes in, then a flat washer, then a
lock
Teflon
nut.
Lock nut. Yep. That's in place. And especially on these top bolts, you have very little space. I'm actually going to put the bolt in from the inside out. And as I put it in, I'm going to slide it through its washer because it's pretty close to the sidewall there. Same thing here. You're dealing with just a small amount of space up in there. And then just for symmetry, I am going to go ahead and turn this one around. I like everything facing the same way. I just like it to be perfect. Now that all the bolts are in, I'm going to tighten it all down.
What kind of tools are you using?
These are just 7/16 wrenches. They both are, but the one has the ratchet on the side, and I really like those. They don't fit in all places because they're quite bulky, but I like using those. They're handy. On the top bolt, it likely won't help us at all because it's pretty low clearance up there, but that's that. The last thing to do is to replace your elbow, which is as simple as putting the first one in. And then the cord will just have to be pulled out the back side, like so.
Cool. And then they just plug that into a standard outlet?
Yep, that's just a 120 volt outlet. That's all there is to it.
Can you put a rheostat on that?
No. Don't put a rheostat on any blower. Unless the blower is specifically called out for it, or unless it's a 12 volt blower. DC blowers are pretty tolerant of voltage control, meaning a use of a rheostat. Very few AC motors tolerate that at all. In fact, it normally damages them.
So to control the draft, you would just use your damper slide?
Yeah, just use your damper slide. But if you're running your evaporator, you're trying to boil, you're trying to make steam, you're going to typically give it as much heat as you can. So leave the draft open, plug it in, and just let her rip.
At this point, let's take an aerial view of your Dauntless firebox with the grates removed. When the damper is open, this will allow air from the blower to enter the firebox freely. When it is closed, the air from the blower will not be able to do its job. It's important to note that if your pressure cabinet is installed backwards, The cabinet will not be perfectly aligned beneath these damper slots.
Let's say someone bought the forced draft at the same time as their Dauntless. So they haven't even assembled their Dauntless yet. At what point in that assembly process would you add
The only thing I would do different if you're putting the forced draft on a brand new Dauntless, when it comes to the part of that video where you're assembling the Dauntless, where you're putting these side spine bolts in on the structure, I would put the one bolt in right here. And in the video, I'm sure I do point out that I do a bolt on the corner, which is typically how I construct something. So when I'm assembling it, I'd put a bolt in here and here. And then I would fill in these bolts all the way up to this point right here. Just leave these five out. And then continue putting the Dauntless together. And when the Dauntless is all set and ready to go, I would then add the forced draft pressure cabinet at that point.
Great. And at this time, will there be anything like this for a StarCat?
No. I don't think we'll ever have this for the StarCat. StarCat, for two reasons. If you're already looking for performance increases on a StarCat, that is the perfect time to start looking at getting a Dauntless. The other reason we'll never have forced draft on a StarCat is because it is not 100% ceramic fiber insulated. It gets fire brick, which protects it from damage from the fire. It protects the arch from getting damaged from the heat. But the insulation that we put in throughout the Dauntless behind the fire brick adds so much to its fuel efficiency and heat control. If you put a forced draft on a StarCat, I suppose you would see the sides glow. The insulation really makes a big difference that we put in the Dauntless. And in the StarCat, it's an evaporator that's fairly small, and there's simply not room for that insulation behind the fire brick. So as soon as we got into the Dauntless, then we knew right away we were going to have it fully insulated.
Right. So the forced draft is really going to intensify the heat.
Yeah, by far. Oh. Yeah, it makes the whole program move quicker.
And that's why we got the different elbow.
Yeah, that's why we send this upgraded elbow along too, just because there's more heat involved. So, you know, fuel efficiency, high performance, American ingenuity, that's what it boils down to.
All right, that's what it boils down to. Thanks, Jim.
You can find Force Draft and many other great accessories on SmokyLakeMaple.com.